V0 helps you build web applications faster, and we've shipped a bunch of features recently. You can now build full stack apps, you can paste in screenshots or connect to Figma to generate your UI, you can one-click deploy your application to Vercel and get your site online, you can even connect and integrate with pretty much any service through the Vercel marketplace and more. So let's take a look, let's actually build some stuff with V0. I'm actually gonna start in Figma, and I generated this form to accept payments for my little e-commerce application. So I'm gonna take this link and we're gonna go over to V0 and we're just gonna import this from Figma kind of as the starting point of our application. So let's start with this and then we can kind of iterate from here. I'm not gonna provide any other context other than basically the image that we're getting from our Figma application and the information that we're getting from Figma. Now what V0 is gonna do behind the scenes is it's gonna take that code and it's gonna start generating React code in a full stack application that we can preview and use inside the browser. So not only can we look at the code, we can edit the code directly, we can see console logs, we can look at errors, we can ask follow-up questions, and importantly, we can preview the actual application in the browser, make sure it's what we want before we go and click that button up in the top right to deploy our application and get a live URL that we can share and we can iterate on. So you'll notice that we have our application. This looks pretty good. We've got our radio buttons here, delivery options, our form, payment options. Okay, this looks okay, but I don't really like this button. So maybe one thing I could do is say, for these, actually the default selected button shouldn't have a black background. Let's fix that. I think that would probably look better. I also think we want to have a monospace font, so that can be a secondary update that we want to make. But you'll notice now when we go through and make edits, we have a fast edit mode where it's going to be able to only change a smaller subset of the file based on the specific component that we highlighted. So helps you make your changes a little bit faster when you're still kind of iterating and figuring out the right UI you want for your application. So I think that looks good. You'll notice that we're using components that we're directly importing from Shad CNUI. That looks better. Yeah, I like that much better. Let's say use a monospace font from Google Fonts. Yeah, let's do that. Let's see how that looks. Now, the nice thing about V0 is I can iterate live. I can cook live here and try out different things. And, you know, maybe I like it, maybe I don't like it. The cost of experimentation, the cost of an idea is very low. I can just use these arrows up in the top right if I want to restore and go back to a previous version. So I have this freedom to explore and try out my ideas and, you know, see what looks right. And we're getting, you know, real production code here. This is React components built on accessible primitives. They are styled beautifully and you can customize them and theme them how you like. I really like this monospace change that we made. It's, you know, I think this is looking pretty good. So, you know, I'm pretty happy with this. I could go back to the latest version if I want. I could just start hacking on this in my local editor. I can just add this to my code base if I prefer. I could copy paste in the code if I wanted. But I think what I want to do is actually deploy this out to Vercel. So I will just make a new project. We'll call this payments. And we're gonna create our project here. And let's go back to deploy and I'll deploy our app. Okay, so it's now kicked off our build. We can actually watch it from here if we would prefer. And I'll just quickly fast forward here till the end. Okay, so it looks like this just finished. We get our URL and then we can click and visit our site. So this will open up our application in a new window. And yeah, this looks pretty good. I like it so far. It's a good place to start. Let's go back to V0. Now, I mentioned that V0 can now build full stack applications. So maybe for example, I wanna say integrate and connect with Supabase or your favorite backend of choice, your favorite provider of choice. Supabase provides a Postgres database, and in a previous video, in case you missed it, I went and set up a Supabase database through the Vercel marketplace. So a first party integration into Vercel where I can have unified billing. And I got that created inside of our application. So we're actually gonna go ahead and use that. But you'll notice back in V0, it asks here, do you want to set up the necessary environment variables to connect to Supabase? So I need the public Supabase URL and then the anon key. So let's go back to here and we can click connect. We'll go to app frameworks here. So we can take this public URL, take this, go back to here, public URL, and then the anon key, go back to here, paste this in, connect. And now those are going to save to my Vercel project. So the great thing about this, I'll open this up in a new tab, is back on my project inside Vercel, if I go to settings, environment variables, we'll see that we have these new values added. So these values aren't being stored in the code inside of your V0 application. They're stored securely in your Vercel app where you can put the proper permissioning and controls around who can access those values. And you can set up different environments in here as well as you're testing with different databases. So we added those environment variables and you'll see now on the left, V0 can create multiple files inside of your application. So we have some server actions, we have our connection to our Supabase database, and then we've updated our checkout form as well. So this allows you to very easily generate multi-file applications, connect to different services, and build more than just the UI for your application. You can ask follow-up questions. Hey, I want to tweak my schema. What's the SQL that I need to run to be able to get the database in the shape that I want? How do I do a database migration? All of these things are now accessible with this web development assistant that V0 is giving you. So it's almost done putting this updated checkout form, and we're kind of off to the races now where we can deploy this full stack application. So we've been shipping a ton of new features to V0. If you haven't tried it out yet, please do and let us know how it goes. And let us know what other videos or examples or demos you want to see us build with V0. Until the next video, stay tuned. Peace.